Would you please welcome Hughes?
Thank you. True story. It's true story. If my son's mother didn't want to hug me, he wouldn't be around.
Yeah,
so.
That's true. Well, on that, we were just talking about the parents pashing.
Yes,
there.
I saw that.
Yeah, sounds like you and your wife don't mind getting a little tongue-heavy in front
of
the kids.
We don't go as much of the hockey as that guy's parents. But he's a hockey player, so that's where he got it from, obviously. Yeah. His parents playing tonsil hockey.
Well, you are returning to what you've described as your first love,
yes.
Stand-up.
Stand-up comedy, yes. Absolute first love.
How does your wife, Holly, feel about that description?
She understands.
Right.
This is how much I'm committed to stand-up comedy. We've got three beautiful children, and I was pretty keen on a fourth. And she said, "Well, if we have a fourth, you have to stop touring." So I kept touring. So got the snip, snip. So yeah, but no, we've got three. Three's enough.
Yeah, true. Very
absolutely.
True.
So Hughesy, your website says, "Don't miss Dave. He's completely unfiltered." That's the new show you're doing. How filtered are you usually? You don't strike me as being particularly filtered.
No, I'm filtered enough. I mean, I'm a filtered tonight. I haven't sworn, so that's good.
Literally been on air for 10 minutes. You should have seen him in the ad break.
No, well, I just, you know, well, I'm. This is in relation to, like, if you go on social media, and I'm having a break from social media, to be honest, but there was a couple of years during the pandemic where I was chewing in my own juices where, yeah, I said some stuff, but then, there's probably people right. Well, my name's probably trending right now, to be honest. I'm on TV now without my name trending, so, I don't know. I didn't answer the question.
You've been with Holly for 20 years now?
20 years, yes. When May 2002 we met, so, and we're still together. And I honestly believe that there she is, that's me and her.
Oh, look at you.
That was actually on our first, and there we are, that was like a couple of years ago. On our first date, we went to a Spider-Man, one of the 4,000 Spider-Man movies in 2002, and Darren Hinch had a radio show at the time, and he saw a photo of us in the paper. He said, "That won't last 2 months." he's been through three livers in that time, so I think we're winning.
And you're trending.
You've been through quite a few hairstyles as well.
Well, yeah, I think for years, I mean, I'm a man, I'm 51, and still have this hairline is, you know, I'm really proud of it, so... And I realised I wasted many years with, like, short haircuts where I could have been, you know, about 2 inches taller.
It's almost a Buffon these days.
Yeah, I think it is a Buffon. And people say, "Is it a wig?" It's not a wig. It's my actual hair, and I really love it.
Oh, that's impressive.
Well, let's talk Masked Singer.
Yes.
It's coming back.
It is coming back.
All new panel except for you and Osha. So what happened? Did they see your social media? Or...
No, the three beautiful girls, Danny, Ursula and Jackie, they all decided to leave the show because they're, you know, more committed to their families than I am. And but there was one point where every woman left and it was just me and Osha left and, you know, he was looking at me like I was the honey badger, you know. I wanted them to stay, but we've got a new panel and we're actually already filming and it's hectic, absolutely hectic. I tell you what, I know why Scary Spice is called Scary Spice. Yeah, I love her and she knows I love her, but, yeah, me and her, we've got a relationship going. She told me to beep off in our first meeting and... But
why?
I didn't. Because I've got my own ideas and she has her own ideas and sometimes they clash. No, I love her though and she knows I love her. But I keep guessing dead people on the show. And she doesn't understand that's my role. And the problem is she knows every international star in the world, you know. So when I say, you know, Taylor Swift, she goes, "I know Taylor." I'm going, "Well, that could be her." And she goes, "Well, she's taller than that." I say, "You haven't seen her for a few months, she might have shrunk." You know?
Who would you most like to see under the mask? Maybe even you? You could do like a prestige situation?
Yeah, I would love to see me under the mask, but I think with my voice, they'd know straight away and they wouldn't allow me.
Yeah.
I just love when I don't know. I love it when the mask comes off and, you know, in previous series, it's like George Columbaris and you're like, you know, I love that stuff. And that happens a lot in this series as well. So. They are better singers than George, to be honest. So, but no, it's a hell of a lot of fun. It's coming back soon.
Mm. Well, head to our website for all the info on Dave's upcoming stand-up shows and keep an eye out tonight on 10 for more Masked Singer character reveals. Dave, thank you for stopping by.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you.